Mark Rogers TV with you once again for part one of our series, Exposing and Tearing Down the BCS Year by Year. The BCS began in 1998, so we begin there. But first, we need a history lesson to get us to the BCS era. Back in the old days, conference affiliation determined who played in major bowl games. The Big Ten and Pac-10 champions went to the Rose Bowl. The Southwest Conference champion played in the Cotton Bowl, a major bowl in those days. The Sugar Bowl played host to the SEC, and the Orange Bowl, the host to the Big 12, or at the time, the Big 8 champion. So you can go year by year and see where the bowl matchups really did not make sense in determining a national champion. Rarely did 1 and 2 play, and many times the matchups were kind of ludicrous in determining a champion. For example, in 1981, Clemson, number 1 in the country, playing Nebraska, number 12, to determine possibly who should be voted the national champion. And of course, there was a vote after the bowls to determine the national champion. Then established was the Bowl Coalition and the Bowl Alliance, the forerunners to the BCS. They at least attempted to get 1 and 2 matched up. There were still a couple of major flaws in that system, and this coming off the heels of split national champions in 1990 and 91. Flaw number one is that the human vote still determined everything, so it was not an objective system. There was no computer results involved. And number two, the Pac-10 and the Big Ten were left aside because they still had contractual obligations to the Rose Bowl through 1997. So what happened there was better matchups in bowl games to determine the champion, but in 1994, for example, Penn State and Nebraska both finished number one, should have played, would have been a great game, but they went to their respective bowl games. And then in 1997, just prior to the BCS in 98, Michigan number one, Nebraska number two, they went to separate bowl games and split the national champion. Okay, we move on to 1998. Finally, we've got 1 and 2, and we've got the Pac-10 and the Big Ten involved. Tennessee, 13-0, SEC champion, they're in. Who do they play? Okay, well, we've got this list of contenders, all with one loss. You make the call. Ohio State, Wisconsin, UCLA, Arizona, Kansas State, and Florida State, all big-time programs in BCS major conferences playing very tough schedules. The SEC was, of course, a top dog then, but the Big Ten actually had the power ranking as the toughest conference in 1998 and beat the SEC head-to-head in bowl games. So who should go? Well, let's break down the one loss for each team. For Ohio State, they were consensus number one for the first 7 weeks of the season before stubbing their toe at home as a 28-point favorite against Michigan State. Michigan State finished 6-5. Not a real good loss for the Buckeyes, who finished at 10-1 prior to the bowls. Then we've got Florida State. Florida State lost one game, and that was to North Carolina State by 17 points. NC State, not really that good that year at 6-5, but they beat the Noles by 17. Okay, on to Wisconsin's loss to Michigan. Pretty good football team that year, number 12 in the country, finished at 10-3 and beat a pretty good Arkansas team in the Citrus Bowl. So a pretty quality loss, you could say, for Wisconsin. Ditto UCLA, losing their one game to Miami 38-35 in that Edger and James game at the Orange Bowl. So UCLA lost to a 9-3 Canes team that finished in the top 20. Arizona, you can toss them out in a way because they lost that one game to UCLA by 24 points. Then you've got Kansas State. Kansas State lost its one game in the Big 12 Conference Championship game against Texas A&M, a team that, of course, won the Big 12. And this game went to overtime, a classic, a three-point game. A&M finished in the top 10 in the country, so that was Kansas State's loss. So I would say Kansas State had the most quality loss, followed closely by Wisconsin. Ohio State was considered the best team most of the season, but had that shocking loss to Michigan State. So who went to the national championship game? Florida State, of course, playing in the ACC, considered like the fifth best conference in the country, and losing by 17 to North Carolina State. Okay, that's 1998. You see where it made no sense. We have all those teams, all those major powers, all finishing with one loss. and Florida State somehow made it to the national championship game. Did they deserve it? It's not that Florida State did not deserve it, but why did they deserve it any more than Ohio State, Wisconsin, Kansas State, and UCLA? There's year number one of the BCS, and what a gem it turned out to be. Would love to hear your thoughts on 1998 in particular and anything concerning the BCS on Mark Rogers TV.